on the rooftop with the Zulu Gestapo.
You think you the shit, somebody in the wings will force you to quit. It could be your crew, a click, or some random kid you smoke Buddha with. Consider me the entity within the industry without a history of spitting the epitome of stupidity. Living my life, expressing my liberty, you gotta be done properly. My name is in the middle of equality. People follow me and other cast to hear them flow and assume I'm the real one with the lyrics like I'm Cyrano.
Still sipping with your well water imported from Pluto, 360 milliliters for all the believers and miles of kilometers. Most cats cannot precede us in the jungle with the leaders. We the lions, you the cheetahs. I'm sorry, who complete us if we come through your receivers? You can play us and repeat us and then take us on Marita. Good Jesus, most step and quietly just make a pussy freeze up, think it over, ease up.
1, 2, 3, most step and begin to rock it all to the tip top. Best in my hip hop. Wow. I said, 1, 2, 3. It's kind of dangerous to be an MC. They shot to a pocket, Biggie. Hold your head with the beat top.
I'm in the tape vaults looking for anything that remotely resembles the words, what's going on, what's happening, brother, right on, flying high. I'm going down the track list and thinking, there's got to be sessions, there's got to be outtakes. And then there's a stack of tapes, and they all have the songs in sequence, and they're on 2-inch tape, which is a multi-track tape, where you can separate the instruments, make a mix to stereo. It was all right there. And you play it, then you have that another holy smokes moment of, I can hear it. I can reimagine it.
Embodiment to do for self. As a teen, it was kinda hard to find a job. I took over my writer's block, ran it like a spot. I'm Pimp C in this game, nigga. I'm a hog, but I'm never feasting on it. Keep speaking on it, God. That's what they say when I'm building. I keep my dialogue street, but still spiritual, like we're deep inside a mosque or a synagogue. I don't preach or go where the sinners are. Keep the fire burning like a slum lord in the Bronx.
I'm gonna go
you love just to get you through, ma. Rhyme writer for 9 to 5 is 25 to life is with the balance of an acrobat of high wires. The pain of a slave with his back feeling like fire, cause the whip is talking to his ass like Knight Rider. Most of these rappers nowadays be sounding like liars. Got visions of guns in their head like a Pied Piper. When I bust, they start to disappear like my lighters, cause they shit is faking in the dreads on Mekhi Phifer. The industry is in trouble, but the industry niggas is fake, so they tend to be in a bubble. So I hit the block where they known to thicken the plot by sticking the cops. Kids be pocket picking the glocks, my man, ballin' out of control. Don't be forgetting that niggas is broken and dishes at a Greek wedding. They might try to run up on you, take your life quick. It's like this when you walk the strip up on a night shift. Good enough. Just to get you through, ma.
Baby, anytime you call me,
you know
I'm coming to you.
You know, why you playing?
Don't
why you playing?
You know I mean it. You can't really count on me.
I like you two and two. Yeah, some old hot shit ready to spit for you. With the songs that you love, just to get you through, ma. This right here, the bare essentials with no extras, y'all. Kept it raw from the school of thought with less is more. Brooklyn is cooking and I'm blessed with the special sauce. I got the soul of a prophet and never take a loss. I'm fresher than the kicks up the box. The kids on the block and the street hungry, trying to get that sweet honey out the rock. Cracking the socks with a click, the road thick and the sour sock. Listening to my black power rock music. Well, it's hip hop, but we be rocking to it. Come on, I'm a river, you a valley. Watch me run right through it. You wanna learn how to do it? Tell the truth in your single first. Little kid went to jail for what you're doing every single verse. Lyrics. Surgery, your beats is more plastic than surgery, and we in the United States of emergency. One of the main reasons none of you lanes worry me is to change lanes like a change plane to change currency.
They wanna know, tell them.
Just to get you through, ma.
Baby, anytime you call
of course
me,
will, cause you know how
I'm
do.
Running to you.
Baby, you know.
Don't you know I mean it? You can't really count on me.
It's a whole lot of shit ready to spit for you. With the songs that you love, just to get you through, ma. Vibe with me for a minute. Shout out to my man George Foreman on the track.
Tell me.
Yes. Hey. Right about now, we gonna listen to the music. And everybody in the sound of my voice, flashing two and twos. Chuck Woolery style. What? Spit for you, the songs that you love just to get you through, ma.
Drop a double nickel on the Knicks. That was 95. Couple of us ain't near the 96. Game banging, cane slinging, had us caught up in the twist. We was middle school fools. Life was rushing past me. Fresh off Tyler's and
bus, fighting up in Pulaski. Uncle hit me off with a zip, now I got some cash. Leave one way you get some money for Nikes, my mama asked me. I gotta sell a nigga bags. Stress weed, million seeds, where the liquor at? Mad Dog 2020 kept a nigga loose. Murder was the case, except a nigga taste the ginger juice. Cause then we gon' be riding on some bullshit. Shoot up a nigga crib, that's some hood shit. And I could give a fuck who in the house sleep. Waking up the neighbor, shoot my tray head at the police, bitch. Yeah. I gotta sell a nickel bags, bitch. Yeah. I gotta sell a nickel bags, bitch. I gotta sell a nickel bags, bitch. Yeah. I gotta sell a nickel bags, chillin' with a bitch, watching LeBron put a 56 on the Knicks. In 2005, police killed my nigga in 2006. Only thing he losing is a pitch, and ain't that about a bitch. If I see that hoe, I got a slug for him. I wanna kill him slow like I ain't got no love for him. I wanna torture him, burn him, drag him to hell with me. This for my nigga that's lurking, working, that's scared with me in these last days. On my last page, fuck a job, I'm whipping his butter, cause crime pays. In these last days, on my last page, fuck a job, I'm serving these cluckers, cause crime pays. I'm a lunatic by nature, yeah. Kidnap a family for this paper, yeah. And if you make it through the day, bruh, yeah. Pray to God I ain't stank ya, bitch. Gotta sell a nickel bags, bitch. I gotta sell a nickel bags, bitch. Yeah. I gotta sell a nickel bags, bitch. Real killer, drug dealer. I gotta sell a nickel bags, bitch. Real killer, drug dealer. I gotta sell a nickel bags, bitch. Yeah. 17th Ave, nigga, Virginia Street. This ain't 2300 Jackson Street, nigga. Real shit, nigga. This ain't no motherfucking museum, no motherfucking exhibit, nigga. I'm really out here giving to these niggas. I'm out here feeding these young niggas, nigga. I gotta sell a nickel bag. Giving out turkeys, nigga, building up courts, nigga, you know what I'm saying? Fuck with the youngest, nigga. What you doing, nigga? All from motherfucking nickel bag, nigga. Shout out to Nick Carmelo, nigga. Get that shit next year, nigga. That block, man, that's some bullshit, man. Shout out to my nigga Mon Summer, man. I gotta sell a nickel bag. I gotta sell a nickel bag. Lambo, we killed y'all niggas in the 90s, nigga. MJ, nigga. Fade away, nigga. That nigga gotta sell a nickel bag. Bitch.
So she thinking that the push gon' do what? So what the push gon' do what? Whoa. Come on, baby, the push gon' make a nigga fall for no. Pay attention, I'ma leave a nigga swore for sure. Come pay attention on the roads alone. When in the pressure to see me, then let him get you on your hold your own. The push gon' make a nigga fall for no. Pay attention, I'ma leave a nigga swore for sure. Come pay attention on the roads alone. When in the pressure to see me, then let him get you on your hold your own. Pressure bust pipes, they sweated a few feet. Got water on their knees, they crying, it's too deep. Me, I'm elite, hesitate only if it's that bitch you see. Ain't no rap for the streets. Mama said, take a deep breath when you speak. So you can scream on a nigga if they don't let you eat. I always remain calm, stress you proceed to make you wanna retreat. Run and get your ass beat down. Now you can't stop this cease. Most niggas ain't gonna follow a two-piece. You might have been getting a beast, catch a swollen mouthpiece. And the deceased from bullets released from his piece. Never been justice, expect no peace. For most of these niggas, it's like stress relief. When the tension squeeze, I tighten up. I do it better under pressure, I get high. Fuck me, bitch. The push gon' make a nigga fall for no. Pay attention, I'ma leave a nigga swore for sure. Pay attention on the roads alone. When in the pressure, you see me, yeah, let him get you on your hold your own. The push gon' make a nigga fall for no. Pay attention, I'ma leave a nigga swore for sure. Pay attention on the roads alone. When in the pressure, you see me, yeah, let him get you on your hold your own. And yo, a lot of niggas crack when the pressure's applied. Cause deep inside, they realize, man, they living the lies. See,
I'm a groovy type nigga, rather two-step with your hands sagging, rag dragging, rather gangbang with your trigger squeeze. Don Callen throw them thang things with your hot freeze, antifreeze, chilling cool, cool with your chilling cool, cool with your hot freeze, antifreeze, chilling cool, cool with your chilling cool, cool with your hands sagging, rag dragging, do my gangbang, bang, bang. Groovy nigga jumped up off the bed, fourth by my third leg, leave the fifth. No L's, no whips. Backyard full of crisps. Barbecues and county blues. Who thinks to be the shit? It ain't much up on our list. Shoot the killer hitting list. Get EBT up off the bitch. Gang banging, fuck a click. Not looking for a scrap. See my gripping done spread around the world. But it's top and low, it's bottom. Mr. Reaper. Reaper. Looking like the Reaper in your driveway. Strange through your living room. Live on the drive-by on a summer day. July 4th will be in June. Black tip, black tip, black tip, black bomb. The sound of that drum that grips that blood snow. Black tip, black tip, black tip, black bomb. The sound of that drum scene. I'm a groovy type nigga, rather two-step with your hands sagging, rag dragging, rather game bang with your trigger squeeze. Don Callen throw them thang things with your hot freeze, antifreeze, chilling cool, cool with your chilling cool, cool with your hot freeze, antifreeze, chilling cool, cool with your chilling cool, cool with your hands sagging, rag dragging, my game bang, bang. Don't make me put a lean to a nigga, spleen jail to a nigga, bad lean. See, my soul was long gone before I got him. He was there before I shot him. It's a Reaper. Looking like a Reaper in your driveway. Straight through your living room. Live on the drive-by on a summer day. July 4th will be in June. Black tip, black tip, black tip, black bomb. The sound of that drum that grips that blood snow. Black tip, black tip, black tip, black bomb. The sound of that drum scene. I'm a groovy type nigga, rather two-step with your hands sagging, rag dragging, rather game bang with your trigger squeeze. Don Callen throw them thang things with your hot freeze, antifreeze, chilling cool, cool with your chilling cool, cool with your hot freeze, antifreeze, chilling cool, cool with your chilling cool, cool with your hands sagging, rag dragging, my gang bang, bang. Tell me more about it in the gutter, where it started with the crippin', brewing Kevin, so what happened? And then the bloods done got it back. Hey,
I'm just an east side nigga. When your niggas saying, show you what it be like, nigga. Hit 'em up, light 'em up like a street light, nigga. Follow me, I can show you what these streets like, nigga. Handlebars of a swing, guns blow like dusty winds. Spin a bend, push his wig back when that revolver spins. Toe tag him, floss flagging like it's all good. Tell niggas tee off like Tiger Woods. Where you from? We never heard of ya. Walking with the murderers.
niggas that I murder you. Steal you like a burglar. See, my soul was long gone before I got him. He was dead before I shot him. Mr. Reaper.
Reaper. Reaper. Reaper.
Ain't no way he's down. Cause I'm born in this pain. Touch your pain, it's a bad dollar. Can I show you this world, baby? Ain't no rules in this life, darling.
And so that's pretty much how I looked at Facebook initially. You know, now it is more of an entertainment type thing. Like, I don't even have to watch reality TV. So much craziness is going on, you know, Facebook. And to me personally, when I just say this because this is something I've been thinking about for a while now. When it comes to your personal timeline, I think that especially if you're trying to market yourself, there's a certain way you should carry yourself on your timeline. Now, if you're like on a private group or something like that, I mean, that's different. But the one thing I hate when I log on about Facebook is I don't think the world needs to know your personal life. They don't need to know your every move that you're making. It's a step-by-step kind of thing. I mean, you could just tell the people who have it attached to them. I mean, I could understand, you know, notifications, but, you know, somebody's going to bring it up. Facebook's again. Okay, if you have a situation going on with you and this other party, why put it on the internet? Don't put it on the internet. I can't stand people calling out the mothers of their children, their fathers, you know, people just putting people down. I don't really act well towards negativity. So whenever I have a day where it seems like it's nothing but negativity on my timeline, I don't even bother to go up there. To be honest with you, I'll switch to Instagram because Instagram is absolutely hilarious. If people would look at Facebook the way they look at Instagram, it would be completely different. And then you have the people, their so-called friends, who egg them on in the comments, and then next thing you know is, oh, well, you know, guess who got locked up for fighting or she went over to his house or anything like that. And I don't like the negative part of Facebook. If you want to handle something with somebody, handle it with them. But I don't really do well with negative stuff or depressing stuff. I don't want to read that. I mean, somebody passed me or something like that, I can understand it's a way for them to let their family know, let the friends know. It's a communication network. But every, you know, 10 minutes, I'm feeling sad, I'm feeling blue, you know, I don't know if it's, are you really feeling that way? Are you trying to get attention? I don't deal well either with people who crave attention. You know, some people might do it, you know, for somebody to reach out to them. I don't know. It's just so many things that turn me off about it if it's in a negative light. I don't like it. But it's hilarious, though. Some of the stuff up there is pretty, you know, some of the people they're posting everything, really funny and really entertaining. But anything negative, I can't do, personally. I want to be able to network with people, make business moves with people. That's what I want to be able to do through Facebook. That's it.
You know what I'm saying? Let me go to somebody else. Turk Blink, you still with me, brother?
I'm still here.
Welcome, man. You know what I'm saying? I want to appreciate you coming to the team. You know what I'm saying? Turk, he is a local rapper. You know what I mean? But that's what he's tuning in Seattle. You know what I'm saying? This is worldwide, bro. So you can't really call yourself local. You know what I'm saying? You'll be downgrading yourself, brother. You know what I'm saying? You know, brother man was the lead entertainment in the house. So I'm gonna talk to you, brother man. You know what I'm saying? How do you truly feel about Facebook? How do you look at Facebook? What are some things you like? And also, what are some things you can't stand about Facebook? Like, you just want to delete your page. Like, look at how you look at it. It's like, oh my God, this same certain person. Really? You know? How do you feel about Weatherman? How do you feel about
it? I mean, coming from where I grew up from and like, watching Facebook, like, I see a lot of stuff up there, like, I just don't completely agree with, because, like, the negativity and basically like what Sophie was saying, like the negativity, like you can't feed into that. But me personally, coming off as a rapper, like, you know, I have an image to uphold, you know what I'm saying? And basically, like, you know, like people want to, when you're doing music, people, like, they love the gimmick. They love the brand, you know? So if you give them that, you know what I mean? I feel like you can benefit from Facebook, and you know what I mean? Facebook has its ups and downs, you know? But me personally, I look at Facebook as networking, as promoting, you know what I mean? I don't really look at it as a personal thing because me personally, I'd rather not be up there if it's going to get personal, you know? I just go ahead and keep it as much as business as possible and just keep promoting my brand and you know what I mean, upholding, you know, the gimmick I have, you know, basically.
So, okay. Y'all heard the best for the one and only, you know what I'm saying? Welcome, man. You know what I'm saying? Welcome, Lee Entertainment. Like I say, you know what I'm saying? He is an artist who's trying to succeed in a rapping career, you know what I'm saying? Appreciate your word, but for y'all, make sure y'all check them out. Hey, brother, man, how can they reach you? How can they see some of your music and stuff like that? What do people need to do?
Well, right now, I have a lot of music on Mac 11 Merv TV, you know, and, like, right now, I'm working on my mixtape. It's coming out. I'm trying to push it out by February. It's coming out, Kane Band, The Weatherman, Volume 1, you know what I'm saying? I'm basically right now working. I'm trying to go ahead and link up with some artists, you know what I mean, try to throw them up there as well, you know, because there's a lot of artists that I know that haven't been heard or haven't been exposed to Mac 11 Murph yet as well as I have. So I want to give them that same time, too, that I was given.
So, okay. That's from other man, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Now, let's get into it. I can't really call him the big guy. Cause he ain't that big no more. You know what I'm saying? I want to give a special shout out, much love to my brother. You know what I'm saying? Rose, he done lost 70, going on 80 pounds. You know what I'm saying? Congratulations on that, bro.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying? So, I heard before we get in this topic, I heard of some stuff that, you know, you're the music manager and Team 103. You know, so I heard there's a project you're working on. Do you mind sharing a light on the project you're working on?
Yeah, working on the Monster. You know what I mean? I got a track that I'm doing for Rim Time. So look out for the track for Rim Time. Look out for the video, too, for Rim Time. Got two features on it, my man DL and also my brother Capo. So look out for that coming real soon. It's going to be a Monster.
Okay. So, Mr. Rose, a.k.a. Perfect Swag, a.k.a. Mr. Get It Done, a.k.a. King Rico, a.k.a. Rose, b.k.a. I don't even know no more. You know what I'm saying?
A.k.a., you know, Mr. 50 Grand, b.k.a. Mr. Okay. Perfect Swag, b.k.a. Mr. Trying to Record.
Okay. Look, we don't get on to this topic, the top of the day, man. Top of the day is Facebook. How do you feel? I'm gonna ask you another question with the topic because Sophia kind of shed a light on it, and I know you do it too. So how do you feel about Facebook? What are some things you like? What are some things you dislike? And then on top of that, I want you to compare Facebook to Instagram.
Okay, I'm different from a lot of people. I'm cut from a different cloth, you know what I mean? I'm a whole nother breed, you know, I'm on a whole nother, everybody else in the left field or the right field, you know what I mean? I'm at shortstop, because all that stuff gets to me. I'm a person you would rarely see me mad, you know that. You're never going to see me mad, you're never going to see me upset. But when I do that, it's a very big issue. So Facebook don't bother me. I love it. If somebody want to put whatever up there, hey, I don't pay nobody bill, I don't pay no cell phone bill, no internet bill, bro, put what you want to put up there. Because if I don't like it, I keep scrolling. I can't say I don't like that about Facebook. I just keep scrolling. And if I get to the point where I do see a bunch of negativity, I flip off, I go to Instagram or something. Then I go back, okay, hopefully they got something different. If they don't got nothing different, there's so many different websites out here you can go to. I go on Vine. I go on Worldstar Hip Hop, you know. So bother me. And first of all, I know I may know 80% of the people on my Facebook. So if I see somebody up there that I do know and they put something up there that I don't like, I know the reason why they put it up there because I know what type of person they are. And if I see somebody up there that I don't know that put up something up there negative, I either scroll past or I just delete them. Sorry, I can't say Facebook never made me mad. I don't care what nobody put up there. I don't pay nobody bill. So especially if somebody said, oh, I don't like what Rico put up there. I don't like what he put up there. I don't care. At the end of the day, I know I ain't about to pay my bills besides one person. So it don't bother me. I mean, but that's I can't say that's the negative or the positive. My positive thing is it's good for communication. I mean, you know, I'm a type of person that I did a lot of bad things when I was young, so I got a bad memory. So I forget a lot of people, I forget a lot of things. So, you know, some of the people I grew up with, I see them right, you know, I go back home in the high school, they speak to me. I'm like, who the world is you? You know what I mean? But it's good for me to stay connected to sometimes, like, oh, yeah, this is First Hill. I want to school this person, you know. So it's good for me to stay, you know, connected with some of the people. And it's good for me to find people that I can reach out that I haven't seen in a while. So it's good on that end. But the negativity, I don't see no negativity to it because I don't let things get to me. I be, you know, I don't know. I just be like, whatever, keep it going, bro. You know me.
So.
You know me. That's how life is. I learned from a long time ago. My mom taught me this. Life is too short. You be stressing over. You be stressing over your light bill. You die over stress. Your light bill is still ain't paid. Somebody else just pick up the slack. You know what I mean? So I ain't got time for that. Yeah. I ain't got time for that. I do what I can on this earth whenever I can, you know. Something I learned yesterday is, you know, you can never live in the present or you can never live in the future. You're just repeating the past. That's all you're doing.
So, so what's the difference? So why you switch? So what is it about Instagram? You know,
I love Instagram. Instagram ain't gotta worry about you putting that dumb up there anyway. It's just a bunch of pictures. I can scroll down and look at the pictures all day. You know, little videos and stuff. Hey, Instagram is where it's at because they be having me rolling on Instagram. I be bugging out, seeing all this crazy stuff people be putting out there. I love Instagram. The reason why a lot of people don't see me on Facebook a lot is because I stays on Instagram. I'm always up there. Even though I may not post and put a lot of stuff up there, but I'm always up there doing something. So Instagram a whole lot better, you know. And you know, it's just like they say, a picture can say 1,000 words. I don't need you to say nothing. As long as you put a picture up there, I'm good. So instead of saying, oh, I'm out with my boo-boo doing this, doing that, take a picture and I can see it and I can keep it rolling. You know, I love Instagram.
Y'all heard the best, you know what I'm saying, from Mr. Rose, a.k.a. a lot of names behind it. You know what I'm saying? Once again, for those who just tuning in, for those who listening, this is the Team 103 Radio Talk Show on God Lives. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Rob Lynn. The topic is today, Facebook, how you feel about it, what you like about it, what you don't like about it, hate about it, whatever. From my sources, Special K has tuned in. Is that true?
Hey, y'all.
Hey, what's going on, Special K?
For those who don't know, because a lot of people don't know what she do, you know what I mean? We don't really put it out there. So when we put out certain things, some people may be bothered about it on the low, but that's okay because we believe in God. He's done this other mess. Special K has been doing a great job working with Rob Lynn and getting this radio show to perfect this and find out the flaws of what we need to do to strengthen it up. And Rob Lynn, she has been working with Special K, and Special K can pretty much do as much as Rob Lynn. You know, she can see everything that's going on right now. So she has been putting in work, man. And I just want to congratulate her on that, man. And she stepped up to Madam Vice President of Team 103 in the high school. She does a great job. That's the way I feel, regardless of what anybody else may think about it. Hey, Special K, I want to appreciate you for all you're doing and all that you're willing to do for Team 103.
Thank you, and thank you guys for believing in me. So, the topic is Facebook and what you like and don't like about Facebook. Okay. My view is, yes, I'm a Facebook junkie. I'm not going to sit here and lie. I get so much entertainment out of Facebook. And I also be the ones that probably can go a little wild on Facebook. And sometimes when I do, I have a little bird that's in my ear. If she sees something that's not right, you know, she'll inbox me and be like, I think you might need to take that down. And I'd be like, okay. Or, you know, she'll just be like, excuse me. And I'd be like, all right, you want me to take that down, don't you? Yeah, I want you to take that down. So thank you, Shafir, for always looking out for your girl, because I can get a little rage sometimes. You know, people be getting on my nerves, and I just be like, ugh. Forget about it, and I just bent it in. She see it, she's like, take that down. So, you know, I always got to, what God said, God got a ram in the bush. That's my ram in the bush. When I can get out of control, she can get me right back into where I'm supposed to
Thank
be
you,
at.
Sophia. Thank you, Sophia. Shout out to Sophia, everybody. You know what I'm saying? The angel in the sky, Casper.
You're welcome. Got to keep it together. Got to, you know, keep the mentoring, and we got to keep all of that in mind, so no problem. Okay. This thing, she does a lot of good things, so I have no problem hitting up an inbox.
So, Kaisa, since we're already in this Facebook thing, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. For those who tuning in, this is Team 103, this is the movement, man. You know what I mean? Before I go to my next person, I said last year, so how you feel when you see, and everybody know that, you know what I'm saying, we're about believing in others, you know what I'm saying, helping each other out, you know what I'm saying, telling people that whatever you want to be, that you can be if you strive for your best, you know what I'm saying. Number one, if you believe in God, you can get anywhere you want to get to. And we're letting people know now, Team 103, we the movement, man. We're going to move with you. We're going to help you move. You know what I mean? So we try to start this positive thing and stuff like that. So let me ask you a question. So how do you feel when you see somebody as a Team 103 member? When you see them on the page, now we try to set out positive traits. Now, not talking about rap and music, not talking about the music they make. I'm not talking about that, but talking about they just in the random conversation. You get on Facebook and they like, you know, F y'all, sticking the middle finger up. I don't care what y'all got to say. F y'all, F whoever liked me, kiss my E, suck my, you know what. How do you feel by, you know, this Team 103 member, we're supposed to be trying to set something positive and try to, you know what I'm saying, provide the way for the youth?
I feel very disgusted, disrespected, and ashamed to even say that they are a part of Team 103. Because I feel like, you know, our motto and our saying, you know, we got to uphold it, and everybody is watching us, and everybody is looking to see when we're going to, you know, if we're going to cross every I and dot every T, or if we do something wrong, you know, they're going to be like, I thought they was part of a movement, or I thought they was part of a real positive group, so why is they up here doing this, and why are they up there doing that? So first off, I'm going to have to inbox them, or like, you know, hey, what's going on? Straight, you cool? Is there anything that we need to talk about? Why are you up here, you know, being unprofessional? You know, just like sometimes I might get out of control, like I said, and then I got somebody that's watching out for me, so I feel like if we're supposed to set an example, then we got to do it right.
So what you agree with that if not, then we all make and get out of hand.
Yes, we all, because we are human, and sometimes we gonna slip.
Okay, and that's what people like you or somebody like Sophia really need to inbox. You know what I'm saying? Calm it down just a little bit. You know what I mean?
Right.
You want to talk to me, anything you want to talk about. Because once again, at the end of the day, we family. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
If something bother you, you can call us or somewhat. I like that.
Okay.
So, once again, you're tuning into Team 103 Radio Show. You know, since she hasn't spoken yet, I'm going to go get her started talking. Gonna get us started. Miss Robin Lynn, how you doing? Robin Lynn, you with us?
Robin Lynn must have
I was trying to compose myself because I feel very passionately about Facebook. I feel full status about Facebook because I just got
full status. You say?
I just got a swole status. Yes, about Facebook. Yes, yes.
Because
Facebook,
you actually experienced some stuff in the past couple of weeks about Facebook. Right? Would you like to share that with us?
No, but I will. I got hacked, and then the hackers went in, and they spammed all of my 5,000 friends. And my 5,000 friends that are good friends reported the spamming. They reported somebody spamming my account. And then Facebook, since it was my account that was spamming, they shut me down. And lost 5,000, 8 years of history, work, pictures, contacts, all of that, with a lot of work behind that. And so, yeah, that was a big shuffle. I use Facebook. I'm on Facebook all the time, and I am taking full advantage of the opportunity of the social networking, but I don't really socialize. I work on Facebook. And I use Facebook to basically promote and advertise, which is one of the reasons why Facebook shut me down without, like, sending me a warning or giving me a chance to prove my identity or anything. Because I figured out that Facebook has been limiting how we post. When we put a post up, like when you guys put a post up, sometimes it won't show up on my wall for maybe an hour or 8 hours later, and sometimes a day later, Facebook decides if they're going to let you see it. And so that's why I always direct post. And so I would sit on there and post like 500 posts a day because I'm going to post it to you, to Special K, send it in messages, go back and do it and push it myself. And so but yeah, I use it to work. I see a lot of people on there. I see a lot of people living their lives on that internet, and it's through that little box, and they make these little images, and then it's almost like, you know how you watch the cartoons, and then on the cartoons they're dropping all these bombs and bricks on the characters, and then they fall, and then they don't die, they get up and they keep going again. That's kind of like how we're relating to each other, starting to relate to each other. This not real stuff. And so we're creating these images, and we're living out these whole lives based on these images, so much so that I've even seen people sitting next to each other with their cell phones or devices, chatting to each other and not talking to each other. So I don't know. I could have summed it up like I started to. Two words, swole status.
Swole status. y'all just heard it from, you know what I'm saying, Miss Sanders, Robin Lynn, the one who really reached out and touched us, and, you know what I mean, she got us on this radio talk show, and it's a blessing to have her also a part of our family, you know what I'm saying. I'm going to just shout some names out. If I didn't call your name and you were in the conference room, just shout your name out. Turk Blee, Jose, Sophia, Kaista, Robin Lynn. Is anybody else tuned in with us right now in the conference room?
Yeah, what up? HDE.
What's up? HDE? Okay.
Yeah.
HDE. How's it going, HDE? What's going on, brother? How you feeling?
Not much, man. Doing good, man. Can't complain.
How's life treating you, man? You doing all right, brother?
Yeah, I'm doing all right, man. Take it one day at a time.
Yeah, one day at a time, man. I know you ain't. Hey, first of all, I want to give a shout out to my man HDE. You know what I'm saying? My brakes was messed up on my car. You know what I'm saying? I called HDE and say, look, man, you know what I'm saying? My brakes down. You know what I mean? What can you do for me? He was like, look, man, I'm on the way, brother. I can do it today. You know what I mean? Came to the house, you know what I'm saying, had me out, changed my brace. I ain't cleaned my rim yet, but we ain't going to get in that on the radio. We're going to say that later on, personal conversation. We're going to get in that. Hey, Steve, do you mind if I ask you about the topic? Do you feel like responding?
Yeah, what's up? What's good?
So the HD, the topic is Facebook. How do you feel about Facebook? What do you use it for? What are some things you like about it? And then on top of that, what are some things that you dislike? What are some things you hate about it, if you have any? What are your likes and your dislikes about Facebook? What are some things you like to see? What are some things you hate to see when you open?
Well, first of all, I mean, you know what I'm saying, Facebook is like a big social network. It's like one of the biggest social networks on the internet today. Me personally, when I first joined Facebook, you know, it was all fun. You know what I'm saying? You go up there, you could read what other people thought. You could, you know, comment on pictures. Everything was good. I mean, me personally, I use Facebook as, first of all, I started using Facebook as communication because I had a couple of family members that were stationed overseas. So me using Facebook, that was a great way for me to, like, keep in contact with them or chat with them or whatever, how, you know, stay connected with them. Nowadays, what I don't like about Facebook is the fact that now, you know, you have kids on Facebook, all ages. So when I get on Facebook and I see people sharing X-rated photos and porno videos and all that stuff up there, it pisses me off because you have to think, you have kids that also get on Facebook. You don't want your kids getting on Facebook and they look at a video and they hit play and it's something they don't need to be seen. To me, that stuff is out of ordinary. Stuff like that shouldn't even be on Facebook, point blank, period.
So I can respect and agree with that. You know what I'm saying? Because in the day, for those who don't know, you know what I'm saying, there are also kids who have Facebook as well, you know. So especially if you know that you got kids as your friend, you know what I mean, you know you definitely need to be watch out what you put up there, you know what I mean? If you don't want your kid to see it, you shouldn't want nobody else's kid to see it. I see where you're coming from on that, brother. So, you know what I'm saying?
Oh.
We don't. Go ahead.
What's happening, big boo?
Who this I'm talking to? Who don't talk with it on?
This be that dude, Black, bro. This be that boy, Carolina. You already know, man. Long time.
She blocked up. What's going on, She Black? You know what I'm saying? For those who don't know, man, She Black go a long way. You know what I'm saying? He's a rock hard with the team. So we still a fan, but it is done. You already know. So She Black,
yeah,
you know, I just want to make sure, Mike, you do music, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So before we get into the topic, let people know how they can reach your music, how they can touch your music, how they can hear it, what they need to do.
To hear my music, you can go to Reverb Nation, / Carolina Black, Black spell BLA2K. I got Coast to Coast mix going on. You actually find me the same way, Carolina Black, BLA2K. Follow me on Twitter. All my links on Twitter, CBLA2K. You know what I mean? Now I'm dealing with y'all, man. I'm trying to get my own show. I'm trying to get like Boo. You feel me?
He's going to be DJing on Vibes Live, too. As soon as I get you to sign up at the site, you got to sign up first. If you guys are going to do any work or anything, you got to sign up.
I was just emailing you. I already signed up. I was trying to find out if I emailed. If I'm putting the right email.
Well, I've been busy. These guys have me back here you know, behind the scenes getting ready for the Team 103 show. And you know what, Carolina? Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something, 2K. They ain't gave me my T-shirt either. So when Grandmama, when G-Mama come on, I'm telling on y'all. I'm telling on each and every single last one of you. Okay, peace out. Peace out.
Okay, hey, so C-Black, you know what I mean? Let's go get into it. For those who tune in, this is the Team 103 radio show on Violine. Shout out to Rob Lee. You know what I mean? Even though she tells me I got to say her name, but I'm going to say it anyway. You know what I'm saying? Rob Lee, love you. So C-Black, so the topic of today is Facebook. how you truly feel about Facebook. What are some things that you like? What do you use it for? And what are some things that you just don't like about Facebook?
There's a lot of stuff about Facebook. I'm just getting news and no news. So I have a lot of stuff that I didn't think they allowed. You feel me? You know, I mean, Facebook off the wall nowadays, though, man. I mean, I can't say much. I use it to network, you feel me? I would use it to push my music. I got all kind of groups and whatnot. You know, that's what I really use it for, just music purposes, man, whatever I'm doing at the time with music. I mean, but,
okay.
I mean, only thing I really don't like about Facebook is when, because Facebook, I feel Facebook is not really one of the networks, that the social networks that people actually follow and see what you're doing, unless it's YouTube. If it's not YouTube, they're not really gonna click on it. Like, let's say your Reverb links or Coast to Coast links like that. Whatever. If it doesn't have to do with YouTube and then you post it on Facebook, people scroll right past that shit. Like, it's gonna get a phone or computer a virus, man. They're not even trying to hear it.
True.
I'm sorry, that's true. I was me giggling. I'm sorry, but he's right though. He's right. If it doesn't have a fight video attached to it or a long paragraph or a picture, a lot of people, you know, they will scroll past it and not take the time to actually, you know, okay, well, let's play it, let's see, you know, things like that, because I know a lot of the artists,
yeah, but
they'll enter themselves in contests and stuff, so, you know, it helps them out that way, too, so.
True. But, y'all don't hear the best. Y'all hear the best. Say it again.
I said Twitter is a whole lot better. People actually click on your link. They actually go follow and see what you got. Like, I don't know. I don't know what it is about Twitter. I think it just reach out further or something. It's just like you don't have to do nothing. Just you tweet something, and so many people that saw what you tweeted ain't got to be following you or nothing. And they know you got all kind of followers. Like, my Twitter be going crazy now, man.
What's your Twitter name, if you don't mind?
C-Black.
Okay.
I got all kind of producers always sending me beats. You know, I mean, I got all kind of music scout, and all kind of mess, man. It just pops up all the time. People was always following and listening. Like, my Coast to Coast mixtape in 3 days had 643 views, bro.
That's good. That's awesome. That's awesome.
Yeah, bro.
That's awesome. Hey.
I'm number two and number
three. That's your boy, C-Black, man. Let's see y'all follow him on Twitter. Check his music out. You know what I'm saying? Before I go into something else, let me do another little roll call, see if anybody else tuned in on the Team 103 Radio Talk Show. You know what I'm saying? We had Turk Bleak, you know what I'm saying, a.k.a. Weatherman, you know what I'm saying, Rose, a.k.a. King Rico, Sophia, a.k.a. Angel in the Sky of Kyaster, you know what I'm saying, Ed Kyaster, a.k.a. Special K, a.k.a. Modern Vice President, you know what I'm saying? Hosky Chopper, the one and only Miss Robin, HDE, you know what I'm saying? Co-Vice of Riders in the South, you know what I'm saying? C-Black, is there anybody else I miss? Okay, so I guess I went round and rolling.
My fault, boo. If you were talking to me, man, I'm in the lab. My bad, bro. My bad.
No. You good. We got about 20 more minutes on this topic before we switch to the How You Go At from 9 to 10. So y'all will stay tuned into that, too. But let me share my thoughts now. You know, Sophia, C-Black, you know what I'm saying? Y'all call me out on the low. I ain't going to lie. You know what I'm saying? I'm one of the ones that I don't really, if you don't tag me into it, I don't scroll down my Facebook just to see what people are talking about. I don't, you know what I'm saying? Because, like you said, it's a big social media. Everybody uses it for everything. People just use it just to talk to other folks and spread out their problems, their issues, stuff like that. Some people use it for music, this and that, this and that. You know what I'm saying? I don't really scroll down just to see what I missed. You know what I mean? If I go on Facebook, it's something I'm gonna put up there. So I don't really catch what people are saying. Unless you want me to see something personally, tag my name. You know what I'm saying? You tag my name. You can put some news out there, tag my name, because I'm at work. You know what I'm saying? I work a lot. Yeah. So a lot of times you piss up more Facebook, I ain't going to see it no way. You know what I'm saying? So for anybody out there, if you piss something on Facebook, you know you want your boy to read it, tag me or I probably ain't going to see it. Now we do have a group page, a 1013 private group page on Facebook. Now, I give you that. I will scroll on that and look at that and see what my people talking about, you know what I'm saying, to keep it real to you. You know what I mean? But as far as I use it for social networking, communicate with some of my people, you know what I'm saying? I got a lot of family, friends, and fans on Facebook. I use it also for entertainment, you know what I'm saying? Rose put a little bug in my ear. And, you know what I'm saying, I heard it from a couple more people that say that they really don't get on Facebook, but now they be seeing my videos of how you go act and stuff like that. They call it entertaining, so they go on Facebook just to see what I don't put up there, or just see how you go act video, you know what I'm saying, because my how you go act, it go on Facebook. It really don't go on YouTube that much, you know what I mean? A lot of go on Facebook, so it feel good to me to know that somebody say, hey, I go on Facebook just to see what you don't put up there, you know what I'm saying? The negative stuff, you know, people cussing each other out, playing each other on low, you know what I'm saying? I don't really pay no mind because I feel like people ain't real no way, you know what I'm saying? They want to say something about somebody, but they ain't going to put the person's name in there, saying something on the low, trying to style some stuff. You know, I don't pay it no mind. I think it's dumb. Especially with us, I think it's stupid. When somebody want to put all their business on Facebook, and then they get mad on the street when they hear somebody talking about it. You know what I'm saying? If you ain't put it on Facebook in the first place, when nobody know about it. But then again, I feel like if you don't put it up there, that's up to you. You know what I'm saying? What you put up there is up to you. Now, on my 1013, you know what I'm saying, you just remember saying something, I don't really pay no mind, but if I look at you as a small part of 1013, like one of the main important people, if I know that you really into 1013 like that, and then I see that something bother you on Facebook, if I see it, you know what I mean, I inbox you myself, hey, bro, what's up, you know what I mean, something you want to get off the chest, you want to talk to me, you know what I'm saying, because I am a great listener, you know what I mean, I'm pretty sure Special K can vouch for that. Rose can vouch for that. You know what I'm saying? I'm a good person that you can always talk to. You know what I'm saying? Other than that, man, to be honest, if it weren't for 1013 and it weren't for me doing my comedy and out here trying to help people and try to bring entertainment, I wouldn't be up there. You know what I'm saying? In the first place, I didn't even create my own page. You know what I mean? I broke up with my woman. And she created me one, so she can try to keep up with whoever tried to keep up with me. You know, so I don't really care about it. I care about it now because, you know what I'm saying, we got a lot of members on 1013, and they got a lot of stuff going on, and then I could just use Facebook just to see what they got going on, man. So, you know what I mean, I follow for entertainment. I really don't look for somebody just running their mouth and all this stuff. They can say that drama, but, you know, that's just my thoughts on Facebook, Instagram. You know what I'm saying? My brother Rose keeps telling me I need to get up there because I love to post pictures. You know what I'm saying? I like to make pictures myself. But fortunately, I haven't linked over there yet. But I think I am. You know what I'm saying? For the strength of my team, because I'm always making 1013 pictures and stuff and little videos. So I think I am going to get on Instagram. Y'all follow me. I'll give y'all the links.
Yeah, because the good thing about Instagram too is that they added last year where you can do 15-second videos, and that's another thing. I like, you know, it's limited 15-second videos.
So you can put videos up there too.
Yeah, but the one thing that I like about it is that it's only 15 seconds. So I mean, you could do, you know, quick promo. people do quick promos for things that they're doing. Hey, I'm DJing at such and such. I'm performing at such and such. And, you know, it ends up on a timeline. So it's not like you go up there and somebody has like a 10-minute thing. It's pretty much like you can a quick commercial for people who are, you know, the artists who are trying to do something. You can post, you know, flyers if you got something going down or something like that. So Instagram to me is much, it's better. More people are on Instagram more than they are, and it's not statuses, they're pictures. If you have something you want to say, you can. If you want to put it in a video, you know, you can. So Instagram is, like, really, really good. And then I just want to say another thing quick, too, is that I don't think what a lot of people take into consideration when it comes to Facebook, you never know when your next opportunity is going to come. Because, like, some of those posts and all that other stuff, I won't like it. I won't comment on it. I don't want to be attached to it at all for the simple fact that I don't know, you know, somebody who's friends with somebody else. Because a lot of people forget, when you comment on a status that other people are commenting on, it's not just your people that can see it. It goes on. It's a whole list of people who can see it. And if my next opportunity is coming, I don't want it to be shut down or have that door closed in my face because of that. So there's a lot of employers who are looking at it. Well, do you have a Facebook page? And they'll ask you, well, can we look at the Facebook page? But even, you know, because so many people are having their own, just like how you got Team 103 going and opportunities are coming that way, you never know. It's not always going to come from a corporation. It can come from somebody making their own move. But if they see that that's the type of thing that you entertain, that's going to come back to you. You might not get that spot, you know, at the club to show your talent for the simple fact that they don't like the way that you carry yourself, because if you carry yourself like that on the internet for millions of people to see, then who's to say you're going to switch up for a showcase of 100 people? So a lot of people don't think about that. And then also, too, there's no conversation on Facebook. Out of a week time, I might have two actual real conversations that don't have to do with celebrities. I don't mind sharing a link. If I listen to something or if I see something positive somebody's doing, I'll share it. Hey, you guys, go check this out. Go to SoundCloud, check this out. So to all of the artists and stuff out there, I think, you know, your drive that you have to keep yourself going, I think is great. I think it's wonderful, you know, that you have that drive and that love for what you do. And, you know, the fact that you keep yourself so busy, the artist or anybody who wants to do anything, anybody listening, if you're so busy that you can't be entertained by it, I definitely salute you. So just keep doing what you're doing. Hopefully the doors will continue to open for you, but don't let somebody else's negativity or what they put up there close the door for you. Don't do it.
Yeah.
So, excuse me, y'all. That
is kind of good how you brought that in, man. I want to share a little quick moment with y'all. And you know what I'm saying? My brother Rose, he's been doing this music thing for over 10, 12 years. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to share some light on what Sophia said. I want to know what, you know what I'm saying, truly what Rose really think about it. Not going against any local artist, but saying something that could be bad about them. A lot of times I feel as you have to watch how you carry yourself everywhere you go. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And everything you do. See, Black, I'm going to kind of like disagree with you a little bit. Not that much, but a little bit. There are very important people that watch you on Facebook. I've been talking to some very high-ranked people about some of the artists that's in Team 103 and about their Facebook, and they actually goes up there to check them out. The problem that came back to me is, you know, they don't really look at your music. So I don't want no local artists thinking they got to change their music up or whatnot. But they go look at your page, and they feel as all you saying is, you know what I'm saying, a random conversation. F you, I don't give a care. I'm better than anybody. I'm the best at this. I don't care what nobody say. It throws a negative vibe to they call me and be like, if that's your man right there, and sometimes I shake it off like, who you talking about? You know what I'm saying? Because they, at the end of the day, it's marketing. You know what I'm saying? Artists, you got to be able to market yourself. So they still going to look for a profession in you when you're a local artist. Their mind think of, can I make money off this guy? You know, but if you pursue yourself just to be a negative person, then to me, I'm thinking that they can't make money off you because all you want to do is stay in trouble or talk junk to somebody. You know what I'm saying? Rosa, how do you feel about that?
Yeah, that's true. I mean, I agree with that. You know what I mean? I agree with 100%. I mean, you know, the thing is about the music, you know, where, you know, and everybody that's artist can agree with me on this. The thing is about music is most of us, we spit where we come from, we spit where we live, we spit what we see. You know, JD can say the best, 80% of rappers' lives, they, you know, they also spitting maybe not what I'm doing, but I may be spitting about what's my ass going or where I want to go. So, you know, the music, to me, music is in me. So I can't switch my music up for nobody. So, of course, I have music that's negative and I have a lot of music that's positive. I'm kind of both, you know what I mean? But at the same time, if you're trying to get somewhere, you do have to watch what you say. Because me, I'm a person that I don't believe in, like, I don't buy, I'm not going to bow to nobody. I don't care because just like you always told me, you know, that battle can make you or break you. So I'm not going to call nobody out and say, oh, I'm better than you. I'm the best in doing this. I'm like, oh, I'm nice in this. How about we be nice in this together? You nice too, bro? How about let's get on the track, let's collab, and let's make something happen. You know what I mean? We all try to get there. At the end of the day, we all try to get in the same place. So, you know what I mean? I ain't never going to do that. But like you said, yeah, your image is going gonna put you out there. You know, even with the music thing, if you're rapping about something that you're not even about and you put it on Facebook or your song up there is called, you know what I mean, the coat move or something, but you're not really moving coat and the boys run up on you because they seen your Facebook page and, oh, you said in that chat, you the coat mover. Where the coke at, bro? You know what I mean? Uh-huh. So you also got to watch out. You guys will watch out for that. So, yeah, your image do play a really big part. That's why I'm like, when I do music, you're never going to hear me spit anything that I haven't done or I'm trying to do, you know what I mean, or that I done lived and been through, you know what I mean? So, yeah, your image play a real big part. So if you're going to put it out there on Facebook, you definitely have to watch what you put out there because you always got to believe the natives is looking. Yeah. Okay. Well, one thing that I learned, we put in work, but haters put in double work.
Yeah, and can I say something, too? Because I'm far from being musically inclined. I mean, if you want me to hum in the background, that can do that. But also, too, yeah, I mean, people have to understand, especially now these days, you have to be two people. You have to be the artist, and then you have to be the businessman. And trust and believe.
Amen.
The
Amen.
Sophia,
can you say that one more time, Sophia? Please say that one more time.
Let me take a sip of my water. I'd be happy to. You have to be the artist. You have to be two people. You have to be the artist, and you have to be the businessman. Now, the crowd that your artist might attract is not going to be the same crowd that you have to sit down at a table in an office and discuss business with, crunch numbers with. They're not going to be, you know, there might be some mixed in there. But you have to be able to separate yourself. I mean, okay, let's throw it out there. We all what Jeezy and Jay-Z, we all heard their music. But trust and believe, when it comes down to the boardroom, turn it off. They are not. They turn it off. It's business. If you want your brand to grow, especially if you are self-starting and that's your drive, you have to learn to separate the two. If not, you're not going to go anywhere. It's kind of like common sense. That's why with the whole Facebook thing, if you're putting it out there and, you know, F haters and all this and all that, okay, if that's not a line in your music, because trust and believe, me personally, even though I'm not heavy hip-hop because I listen to so much other stuff,
I never believe anybody should have to censor their music. Never believe, don't, because if you censor your music, you're not actually, it's not coming from your heart. You're not giving your soul. You're going to give what you want, you think people might like, instead of what you actually believe in. So don't ever censor yourself to appease other people. Do what your heart feels. But trust and believe, you have to learn at some point, you have to cut it off and handle business. That way you can take yourself to another level.
I agree.
And then once you master that, that's how they get to branch off. They don't get to get these beverage deals and these being part of these teams and investment deals by acting like that. It's not going to happen. It's just not going to happen at all. You can't be in a suit and tie at a board meeting and act like that. It's not going to go down.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Yes.
This is Joe Doe. I'm beeping in. You know, been listening to y'all for the last 15 minutes.
Joe, before we go into break, and G Mama bring how you go act, you know what I mean? We're going to get a photo of you after the photo of you if Rob Lynn don't mind. She going to play a theme song by Rosé. After the theme song, you'll be tuned in with G Mama with a how you go act. But today's topic is, first of all, Joel, JoJo, he's one of the four hosts in the team on three. Shout out to JoJo. JoJo, what's good, brother?
What's up?
So, JoJo, the topic is Facebook. How do you feel about Facebook? What are your likes about Facebook? And what are some things that you can't stand about Facebook?
Now, I'm going to go with the one of the things I can't stand first, because I've been seeing a lot of it. You know, black people especially has marketed fight videos. For what? I mean, I don't want to see that. I don't want to see nobody. They got it whooped. That's them posting. You're going to post it funny, especially when they get hurt. They probably got killed. Ain't no telling. Then you're looking up 2 weeks later, they charged with assault, going to jail. And they're 16, 15 years old. You know, and then just like you said earlier, I heard that if you're going to post about your Facebook, about your business, don't say nothing with somebody comment on it, because you're putting it out there for somebody to comment on it. You know, just like you said, if you're going through a problem, somebody going to be that person that sit there and say, hey, what's wrong? You need to talk? Hit me up. Let that be the conversation. It ain't got to be, oh, you know what, I'll be honest, I said it one time myself, but, you know, I made a statement. I said, if somebody don't like me, don't like me. Don't like me. But at the end of the day, I'm just like a star. I'm straight up. I'm going up no matter whether they hate me or not. So, I mean, for them to sit there and keep carrying on about somebody don't like them, this and that, I mean, what is that doing? They ain't putting no money in your pocket. Ain't feeding your kids. Ain't paying your light bill. Ain't doing none of that. And the thing that I like about Facebook is, which I have done, I have reached out to family members that I didn't even know I had. I reached out to friends from way back in school when I moved to North Carolina that I haven't seen in years. I keep in contact with my four horsemen brother and my team 103 members. You know, it's always, if you can't talk to them, it's always, okay, what's going on this Friday? Let me look up and see who posted something. Let me see if we're going to have a cookout this week, if we're going to have that chicken or fish fry this summer. I mean, it's always something can be on. But that negative garbage that has been feeding Facebook for a few months that I've seen, it's stupid. It's stupid. It's ridiculous. Now, the best thing, one of the best things I have seen, you know, if you're in an area where you have a pedophile and you don't know about it, and you're posting that, that's fine. That's good. That's information. That's information. You know what's going on in your surroundings. Or if, you know, you have a school shooting and you can't get to nobody and, you know, you can't use the phones and internet. Oh, somebody call my mom. I mean, use it for a purpose. You know, don't drag it down and, you know, you're looking at police looking at it. You're looking at other people looking at it. And they like, what in the world? Really? I mean, that ain't for me. I'm a grown man. I mean, all that fight stuff and who got knocked out last week, oh, well, that's their fault. I don't want to see it.
Okay. Y'all heard it best. For the one and only JoJo, know what I'm saying? When the credit manager at Rim Time in Greenville, you know what I'm saying? Y'all need some rims, holler at my man. But, yo, I tell you like this, though. You don't pay, you can't play. Coming to jack you up. That's how it's going to be. So if you go to Rim Time, pay your bill. If you don't pay your bill, don't get mad when you see JoJo knocking at the door and jacking this stuff up. I want to thank everybody for tuning in for today's topic of Facebook, how you feel about it, what you like, what you dislike, you know what I'm saying? We're going to tune in to Rob Lynn. Rob Lynn going to play the theme song. Right after the theme song, G-Mama bringing you the how you going to act, and you best believe ready for this one. Rob Lynn, we ready?
Well, it's about that time.
This is G-Mama. How's everybody doing? This is G-Mama. How's everybody doing?
Hi, G-Mama.
Hey.
You know, I'm just doing fine. You know, I got a couple of my grandkids on the line. Special K, you still with us, honey? Special K, you still with us? Kurt Bleak, brother man, you still with G-Mama? You still around? Mm-hmm. We're going to get right into this, how you going to act. Who I want to go to first? C. Black, you still with me?
I'm still there, bro.
This is not bro. Excuse your conversation. This is not bro. This is G-Mama, huh? Mm-hmm. This is G-Mama. This ain't no bro.
I'm sorry.
And how you doing today?
Ooh, you better pay attention. You better pay attention, son.
This is G-Mama. So, C-Black, can I ask you a question?
Yes, ma'am.
There you go. Okay, I just love it. So, C-Black, how you going at? You got any kids? You have any kids, honey? You have any kids?
Yeah, I got three of them live with me.
Okay. So how old is your youngest child?
My youngest child is a year old.
Okay. Perfect. How you going? Rosie, are you ready for this? I've been telling Special K about it, too. So, C-Black, here's the deal. Here's the thing, C-Black. So, you dating this girl, you know, you've been dating this girl for about, I don't know, 6 months to a year. You've been dating this girl for 6 months to a year, you know, started liking her, you got to stand over the house, you done met your kids, you know, your kids, all 11. So, she's cooking you dinner, and she realized that y'all didn't have nothing to drink.
You follow me?
Mm-hmm.
She's cooking you dinner, and she realized y'all didn't have nothing to drink. So she tells you, honey, can you go get us some soda or something, you know? So, of course, you get your car keys, you run out, you go get something to drink. But in the midst of it, you seen one of your homeboys, and you got caught up in a long conversation. Mm-hmm. Everybody still following me? Mm-hmm. You got caught up in a long conversation. Then by the time you come home, when you walk in the door, you realize that your girlfriend is crying. She got this depression. It's like her face is all bald up, done turned black and blue. And you ask her, well, baby, what's wrong? She tell you, she say, ah. She's like, baby, can't you sit down? Sit down and please listen to me. Sit down. I'm sorry. She's like, don't listen to me. I'm sorry. What's going on? What's the problem? What's up? How you gonna act when your girlfriend tell you that you were gone too long? And your one-year-old started to cry for her death. And she tell you, she says, I just wanted to put my hand over her mouth just for a little while, and I realized that she's no longer breathing. How you gonna act, she black? Well, you realize that your girlfriend done killed your child.
I'm going straight to the point.
How you going?
You're going to jail. I don't play.
Well, what about your other kids?
Man, my mama, I'm had to call my mama, man. This is good. Bro. I don't play with my kids. That's close to my heart right there. You play with my kids, man. I'm sorry.
That means she got to die. She got to go.
I don't think my mind can take none of that accident. Nah, you a human being. You know that's a baby. What did you do? Nah, you got to go. I'm sorry. I probably choked out. I'm sorry. I don't beat on women. But, you know, that's my baby. That's my baby. Don't nobody else but my kids. The girl, she could leave. My baby always going to love me, even when she hate me and talk down to me, to my kids. It don't matter.
So, my baby,
she got to go, too. Lord, forgive me.
There you go. You heard it from C. Black. Rosé, you with your mama? Rosé?
For sure. I'm still in here, baby.
How you doing, sweetie? You doing all right?
I'm doing great,
Grandma. I see you losing weight, looking like good there. Go ahead with your bad self, son.
You know, I do what I do whenever I can do. It'd be nice to what I'm doing.
What you got on?
My work clothes. That's some spandex.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay.
We want to be cold out there. All right. Excuse me, Dixie Mama. I'm sorry.
It's okay, Shay. It's okay. God bless you, baby. God bless you. You already know how we do. So, Rosé, you mind if Dixie Mama asks you a question?
First of all, ask it to me. Ask it.
So I just want to know, you know, how you gonna act in different situations, you know. So
okay.
You guys, I ain't gonna build a picture business out there, but let's just say you got a girlfriend that you've been dating about over a year.
Okay.
You understand? You got three boys, right? You know.
And I do.
So,
yes, I do.
True. So she cooking in the kitchen and she say, you know, Rosé, Rico, Sadie, whatever, Cuckoo Pie, whatever she called you, we need some soda. Can you go get us something to drink? So you leave to go get your family something to drink, and then you see your little brother. You know your little brother, Big Boo. You know how he can talk all day. So you don't got caught up in a conversation.
And by the time you come home, your girl is crying. So immediately, you've been the person you are. You're like, well, baby, what's going on? What's wrong? And she said, it was just chaos. Please forgive me. It was just chaos. And the kids were just running around and they were crazy. And you know what I'm saying? I just went to pop them, you know what I'm saying, back of the head. But his head hit the corner of the table. He ain't breathing. So how are you going to act when your girlfriend tell you that she popped your son on back of the head and his head hit the table and broke his neck? How are you going to act?
Well, you know, for y'all that do know, that know my BM, I won't have to do anything because she's going to do it. So if I kill her, but y'all that do know, then I ain't got to worry about it. All I walk out and call her, bam, it's done. But at the end of the day, you know what I mean? Like I said last Wednesday, a lot of us, we always say what we going to do, but at the end of the day, we never know what we going to do until we get in that situation. But this situation is different because this is kids involved. I know what I'm going to do, and she got to go. She got to go. I already know. I'm going to be so mad at those fans off. Ain't no telling what she been doing. Sometimes I don't know my own strength, and I can see me doing the same thing to her, eye for eye. I'm going to pop on back in the head, boom, hey, hit the table. It's done. And just like you were just asking Black a while ago about the whole going to jail and what about other kids, nowadays you get less time for murder than you do for drugs. You know what I mean? I do them 3-4 years, whatever they give me. I go in there, be nice, give me 2 years or 3 years of house arrest. I do that.
Oh,
my other kids don't understand the reason why I did. I'm back home with them 2 years. I'm chilling.
So,
oh, you right. In the same
asylum. Yes, ma'am. Yes, mama.
I may do, but I go in and do whatever that little bit that give me. I'm going to do that little bit, and I'm back home on house arrest, and I'm back good, and I'm back home, I'm back doing what I got to do for my other kids. You know what I mean? Because, like I say, that's when a situation with your kids, you can't see that you can act calm. You know what I mean? You're going to do something that you're going to do an out-of-body experience type of deal. You know what I mean? Especially when you're talking about your kids dying, you're going to have an out-of-body experience.
Yeah, man, I know that I would just probably just lose my mind. So it really what I said probably is dumbed down because, you know, they probably really would have to straightjacket me, man, seriously.
Yeah,
they
are. They are.
Straightjacket.
So, Phil, are you still with us, Sophia?
Yes, I am.
How you doing, David? You're all up in VA. How you doing?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing like shit. I told my grandson, Big Boo, okay? And he told me that he never got you in a how you go act. So now.
Yeah, this is my first one.
Oh, G-Mama got to get you, girl. G-Mama got to get you. Stop. With you. And let's change it up just a little bit. So your baby daddy come to pick his kids up, you know? Take him out and leave family fun day. Okay? He pick him up, he leaves. Okay? You get a phone call that he is in the hospital. The sad news is your kids didn't make it. The police officer stopped you, and this is what I want to know how you're going to act. The police officer, when you ask the police officer, well, what happened? How you going to act, man? Your baby dad's still living. You know, he good. He got like a little concussion or something. He finna be up out of there. You know what I mean? But the police officer reads your report and she say, your baby daddy flipped the car. It was his fault because he was texting while driving. How you gonna act?
God. And my babies didn't make it. Well, me personally, because I have been, I guess, blessed with a really calm spirit, but that would
But the only thing is that I wouldn't seek anything, any physical thing against him. I mean, yeah, he was in the wrong, but I don't know. That's kind of tough because it's one of those things because anytime somebody loses their child at the hand of another, the last thing they want to do is see that person or come in contact with that person. So it's not like I'm going to go and pull the plug on them or anything like that. You know, there probably would be some kind of disruption, you know, in the hospital. But, I mean, I'm not going to pull any time for it because, I mean, my world is gone. I'm not going to, you know, I don't know. That's a tough one. Now, if we flip back over to the other one, and if I leave to go get some juice and I come back, I don't care if it's red juice, grape juice, or a Shasta, and I come back and my baby was crying and you hit my baby and, oh, and we only been dating for 6 months? Oh, no. See, that's going to be a whole nother kind of response. I'm going to handle my baby first, but trust and believe, once I handle my baby, it's going to be completely, completely different. It's going to be bad. It's going to be bad, and I'll take you to court. I'm trying to get you some time because I want you, because one of the worst things you can do is be sitting up in jail and somebody asks you, what did you do, and you have done something to somebody's mama or grandmama or somebody's child. So that's how I'm going to get you. I'm not going to jail. Oh, yeah. You going to jail.
Amen.
That's how I'm going to get you. Yeah, that's
how
I'm going
to get you. You heard it from Sophia. HDE, you stay on the line with us, darling? HDE?
He left.
Okay, what about Turk? Turk still with us? Okay, now I got a good one. Special K, you still with me, darling?
Curtis, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Ma'am.
Curtis, are you still here?
No, I got one for Kai. Let me speak to Special. Special K. How you doing, Special K?
I'm fine. How are you?
You doing all right? Mm-hmm. Good to hear you again, girl. Oh, yeah. Gee, mama proud of all the things you've been doing. Mm-hmm. Gee, mama proud of you letting people know that, hey, you're a better woman. You feel what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm.
Yes, ma'am.
But I can't stand when people act like they had a perfect life. You feel me? I can't stand when people act like they ain't done nothing wrong, because we all has. You feel me? Mm-hmm.
Yes, ma'am.
Don't make me pull nobody's closet out. Open your closet. See what you got in there. You feel me? Mm-hmm.
Yes, ma'am.
Papa, can't look at yourself. You feel me, girl? Don't put that stuff on my. Mm-hmm. But I got something I got to ask you.
Okay.
How you go up? So, Special Code, here's the top. You know, you got two boys, right? Is that right?
I have three.
Three? What are they ages, if you don't mind, D-Mama, asking?
They're 10. My oldest is 10. My next to the oldest is 8, and my baby is 7.
Okay. Now, let's say this is the situation. Your 10-year-old done got out of hand from school.
Okay.
Fighting or something. From fighting or something. You see what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He come home, you decide to check your booty. Uh-huh. Oh, but he get all smart with you. You can't tell him nothing. So you get to whipping that booty, tying that tail up. But the whole time, your 7-year-old is laughing at him, picking at him. Mm-hmm. Your baby boy, got your ass whooped, you don't got whooped, that's what you get. Mm-hmm. You go back in the front room to turn on some TV or something, and your middle-aged son says, "Ooh, Mama, you need to come see this, Mama." When you run back there, how are you going to act? When you realize that your 7-year-old was picking at your 10-year-old, your 10-year-old done got mad and body slammed him. The problem is his head hit the bed rail and he is no longer living. I do go out. Your 10-year-old done got mad because your 7-year-old picking at him, and he done got right mad because he was already mad. And he sit there going that damn room that there and pick that damn little 7-year-old boy and then throw him on the bed rail and then he done bust his head open and he's no longer looking. How you going to act, Special K?
To be honest with you, D-Mama, I don't know how I would act in that situation, honestly.
Rose, I think I got it, Rose. I think I got it. How you going to act, Special K?
I don't know. That's tough. I really don't know how I would act in that situation.
That girl, sometimes in situations, you just don't know how to act. You know, I mean, you don't know how you would act because it all depends on how you're feeling, how you've been drinking, how you got some weed in you. You know, all that depends on how you're feeling. You see what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. Depends on have you been going through something? You know, that's a tough one for me. D-Mama don't know how to answer that. Now, I'll probably start off with a slap, though. I tell you that. A slap is coming. Sure is. Robin Lynn, how you doing?
G-Mama, I'm fine, but all of them ain't fine because they still ain't giving me my T-shirt.
What's the problem? We need to find out what the problem is.
I get up in the morning and I pray for them, and I come in the chat room and I work on make the place all dust up and everything and mop the floors. When they come in, then it came up in Vibes Live and took all over. Then in Blunt Top Vibes and Show. Matter of fact, Special K holding out too, because she got a big announcement. So you make sure you check her. Don't mess around and get chin checked holding out. Yeah, she got a big announcement to make. But I'm fine, D-Mom. I'm fine. I'm cold. I got the goosebumps because I ain't got my teeth.
We don't have to talk to these 10-103 people and find out why you ain't got no shirt. All this hard work you're doing don't make no sense.
I'm naked.
I ought to be ashamed of themselves. Mm-hmm. You know what you ought to do? You ought to strip them down naked and drag them on the road with your car or something. Mm-hmm. Let them hear road burn on their naked body. Shame on themselves.
They move out.
Who that?
No, it's Big Boo Paul.
Mm-hmm. I've got to go to JoJo now. Mm-hmm. JoJo, how you doing? How you doing, JoJo?
I'm doing good, G-Mom.
I'm going to get you next, but I'm going to get Robin Lynn right quick. Mm-hmm. I'm coming to you, JoJo. Don't go nowhere. Mm-hmm.
I'm right here.
Robin Lynn.
Yes, ma'am.
I just want to know, you know, how you act. If you dating the guy, now we know your kid's a little older. Am I correct?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So you dating the guy, and you decide to leave out to go do something, to go get something, whatever you got to get, whether it's a bag of weed, I don't know, whatever you got to go get. I'm just thought that was just a joke. Don't go for that. You decide to go to the grocery store to get some groceries so you can come home and cook candy for your man and your boys, all them all over. Mm-hmm. Sure enough. But you decide to come, when you come home, you blow the horn. Come get the groceries, come get the groceries. All y'all grown men and us. And you notice ain't nobody move. Uh-huh. So you decide to go in the house and what's going on? Your boyfriend jumps up and says, baby, you started. He put his hands on me first. He started it. And you're like, what could you look? And you see that your boyfriend got in a fight with your son, and he choked him to death.
Oh, no.
He tell you, I was just trying to calm him down, really. I didn't think that he was going to die. I just wanted to stop him. I just wanted to slow him down. I didn't know he was going to stop breathing. I thought he was playing. Please forgive me. Please, baby, forgive me. Babylon,
Mm-mm.
How you going to act? How are they to respond?
I think probably like I am right now, I wouldn't even know what to say. I wouldn't know what to do. Just so much would spring up inside me. I imagine I want to run to my child and at the same time want to you know, grab and hurt that person at the same time. I can't even imagine. I think I'm stumped on this one, G-Mama. I'm speechless.
Ooh.
On this one. My mouth is open.
Ooh.
On this one. Yeah, that's a hard one. That's one of the ones where you really, really can't say what you know. I can't say.
Bro,
I just can't say. Mm-hmm.
Bro, that's a tough one. That, hey, JoJo.
Yes, man.
JoJo.
Yes,
man, you know, I know you got a little girl. How your little girl doing? She doing all right?
She's lovely. She's lovely.
Mhm. And I also know you got a son too, don't you? I spent everything, ain't it?
Oh yeah, just turned 20 years old.
20 years old. Mhm. Congratulations. You done an excellent job with it. I mean, excellent. They said they said good fathers are hard to find. You know what I tell them? Not in Team 103, they ain't. You feel me? Mm-hmm. So, Joe, so your son and your daughter is at the house, you know, they're all playing. You know, your son wants you to take him up to the road to his girlfriend's house. Mm-hmm. You done told him he ain't going. So now he done broke bad at you. Mm-hmm. He so did done broke bad at you. So, you know, you got to fist that thing. And you tell your sit down and shut up, bust you in your face. You know, she go in the back room playing the game. The daughter go in there. She tells him, you know, that's why you shouldn't talk back to daddy. And you, but you hear this. Shouldn't talk back to daddy. All you hear is boom. So you get up, what the what? You walk in the room. And your son's still playing the game. After he done backhand your daughter and her neck done hit the dresser, and she is no longer breathing. How you gonna act, JoJo? How
that's kind of rough right there. I mean, cause
he's still playing the game, right? I don't even care. He's still playing the game. She dead, lying on the floor. How you gonna act, JoJo?
I know. For one, I'm trying to get her straight now. I'm trying to figure out what happened, what went wrong, and I know something had to go wrong. He's sitting there just playing the game. But at 20 years old, I think he would get roughed up a little bit. But he's gonna have to live with that one for the rest of his life. More than likely, you know, he end up going to jail. I mean, he had to eat that one. But I can't see myself killing my child, you know, over it, because then, you know, that would make no difference, have two dead children, you know. But he had to eat that one. He gonna see see when I turn green, though. He will see that. He will see when I turn green, because he got to have the backhand just as well. But I would let him take that punishment, eat it, because that guilty conscience that you killed your little sister over, you can't go nowhere, that'll stay with him for the rest of his life.
Oh, yeah, he gonna be hurting on that.
Yeah, he'd be hurting on it. But he got to eat that.
Before I carry along, because I got a question I got to ask Special K. Before I carry along, is there anybody I missed? Anybody say hi? Okay, I'm gonna keep going. Special K.
Yes, ma'am.
So you know, so I've been talking to Rob Lynn. You know, Rob Lynn been doing a great job. I've been talking to Rob Lynn. I've been talking to my grandson, Big Book. You know, Rob Lynn tells me that you have something going on. something coming up, but she ain't fully tell me. So let me ask you, what are you working on? What is can we expect from you?
Well, your son Big Boot gave me my own talk show. So I am working on that as we speak right now. Also, he gave me a co-host, which is Shafia. She's going to be my co-host.
The angel in the sky. Hey, girl. Okay, go ahead on. What's your talk? What is this about? What's the name of it? Let me talk to me.
It's called Grown Woman Status. Basically, it's a show for ladies only. Basically, we're dealing with everyday situations, but knowing how to handle them in a grown woman maturity.
Okay. You know, that's good. I like that. Let me just ask you a question before I get on somebody else here. So what do you call a grown woman? I'm just asking, you know, what you call her? When do you see a woman and you say, you know what, that's a grown woman right there? How do you recognize her? Do you know we got some men folks listening, you know? We got some young teenage men listening too, and they don't know when they see a grown woman, you know? All these flim flams and they've been messing with. So let me just, I'm asking you something else, so don't you go on the record, you go on, I'll come to you, Matt. So when do you see that, hey, that's a grown woman right there? What is something that you can see that you can say that's a grown woman right there? You go ahead, though.
Okay. My definition of a grown woman is a woman that really don't let a whole lot get to her anymore. You know, she can handle her own. She really don't need a man to take care of her because she can take care of herself. And like I said, just when certain stuff comes her way, she knows how to brush it off and keep moving in life. And that's my definition of it myself. Like, she really don't need nobody to take care of her because she can do it herself. And she's not needy.
Y'all better watch out. That's her definition of a grown woman status, and it's coming soon. And co-host, Miss Sophia, how you doing, children?
I'm fine. How are you?
Wait, you know me, G-Mama, just rocking out like it's hot as an eye day. You know what I mean? These young boys ain't ready. They ain't ready.
So, all right, now.
From my understanding, you the co-host, right?
I have been asked to be.
So let me ask you before we carry on. You know, y'all bringing this show, grown woman status. So what do you call a grown woman when you see one? Like, you see her and you say, okay, you know what? That's a grown woman right there. I mean, you give me what you think.
A grown woman to me, it goes in actions. I will look at a woman and her actions and how a negative can be turned into a positive, how she's able to handle everyday adversities. You know, grown women, they do get knocked down, but grown women also pick themselves back up. They're able to hold their head high, knowing that at any point their head can be hung low, but they know how to bring that head back high. They also are able to empower other women, bring other women on board, you know, be uplifting, be positive, not negative. You know, just being able to make the best out of the situation, and if a negative situation comes her way, she knows how to not really turn her back on the situation, but how to bring good out of that situation so that situation won't turn negative again. So it's just, there's so many different ways that a woman can be grown. It's definitely not materialistic. You know, being a grown woman has nothing to do with obtaining objects, but pretty much being grown, a grown woman is, it's more of that person's mentality. Grown women are grown from within the brain, you know, because if mentally, if you're not a grown woman,
you're not going to think, speak, act accordingly like a grown woman. So it is, it goes with that.
Okay, okay. You know, before I go to JoJo, because I think JoJo has something he wants to share with the team. Rose, are you still on the line? Rose, you still with us?
Oh, yeah, I'm still here.
So, you know, Rose, you know they were giving us their definition of a grown woman. And they're going to be bringing the talk show grown woman status, and they're going to be talking about, you know, things you deal with, you know, things you got to be able to adapt with, stuff like that.
Okay.
And you've been a good man. I know that you are. Okay.
That's right.
Then you take care of your kids and your girls too. You feel me? And you always been there for your family. So let me ask you a question. What you see, like, what is your definition of a grown woman? Like, when you see one, you like, you know what? That's a grown woman right there. You know, what is your definition? You give me your thoughts.
Well, you know, not to disagree with what the other everybody else already said, you know, the host and the co-host, but me as being the type of person I am, you know, I'm always just like Sophia just say, you know, I look at a woman's actions, you know. I look at, you know, like you said, I don't look at her. It's not about her status. It's not about what she got. It's not about what she's driving. It's not about none of that. It's about her actions. It's about, you know what I mean, her being woman enough to know every day it's not going to be a good day. She can have her bad days. She can have, you know, she can have good days. And like Sophia just said, whatever knocks her down, you know, it's also going to make her tough enough to get back up and realize some mistakes and what she do. You know what I mean? But on the other end, not to say especially Kate was wrong, but my ideal is if I'm looking for a woman, if I'm looking for a good woman, I don't need a woman that's going to come and tell me, oh, I don't need anybody or I can do everything myself, because at the end of the day, we all need somebody. I put myself as, I know I'm a good dude, you know what I mean? You can, at least I think I are, but I'm never going to say I don't need anybody. I'm able to do everything by myself, but I'm not going to say I don't need nobody, because we all need somebody. At some point, we all have to get where we're going, you know what I mean? We have to have that little push sometimes. We have to have that person that we could talk to mentally get us ready, too, you know what I mean? But, you know, like I always say, in the same way like me and Big Boo always say, if I'm bringing steak to the table, least can you put some string beans in here with it. You know what I mean? That's all I had to full of side dish.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So, you know, I don't wanna be dating a woman. I say, hey, I'm trying to talk to a woman, and you know, I'm like, hey, can I pay for dinner or something for you? And she be like, oh, I got it. You know, no, I got this. Because me, I'm an old school person. You know, if I'm in a relationship with a female, it's about I'm taking care of you. You know, I don't want to go, I don't need you. It's good that you can do everything, but, you know, at the same time, you know, I mean, we all need somebody at some point. So it's not as being I can do everything myself. It's being able to do everything yourself. You know what I mean? So, but that's why I look at a woman. Me, I don't look at a woman for her size. I don't look at a woman for her beauty. I don't look at a woman for what she has, because I can tell anybody. I can find a beauty in any female. I don't care what she looks like, how much she weighs, how old she is. I can all, because every woman has something pretty or beautiful about her. It may be the way she carries herself. It may be her eyes. It may be the way she talks. But everybody knows me, and I always say this. I love a woman that loves herself. At the end of the day, I love you. I don't care if you could be the ugliest woman alive. If you go out and you say, you know you the chain, you know you hot, you know you looking good, and you could be looking like Buster Douglas, I'm in love with you. The brothers be like, yo, you not good? Yes. And you check out that swag. She love herself. You know what I mean? You love you? I love you too, boo-boo. You know, that's just me. So the best thing for me, for my advice to a woman, is to love yourself before you ask for another man to love you. You know, that's my whole thing. Yeah. But like Sophia said, you have to show it in your actions, though. You can't be stuck up. You know, you have to show it in your ex. But, you know, that's just me.
Okay. JoJo, you still
over here? Yeah, I'm still over here.
before I ask you the same question, I got some information that you want to share with the team, right?
Yeah, I want to share some information. If y'all go to my page, or y'all seen on Derek's page, I have a very good friend of mine. Her name is Keisha Sanders. She runs a little bakery at her house. She's a strong woman, two jobs, kids doing her thing, trying to put her bakery out there. If you go on Facebook, it's facebook.com, Sugarfoot's Bakery. Go on it. Check out what you need. She stays over there in Goldsboro. And she got what you need, cakes, pies. I mean, she do it up. So everybody, check it out. Oh, she does it up. She does it up.
You know,
I got five on it.
I'm writing my book. I'm starting back on my book. It's called From a Boy to a Man, and it's a little memoirs about myself, about how these little young men are being raised. I got myself in the book, so it starts out with me. So I can't. No man can say if they read the book. I hope they would. You know, I hope it. You know, it does good. But if you read that book, I can't share any experience with anybody without having been through it myself. So that's the next thing.
All right.
So there's a cake and a talk show coming out. You know, co-hosted by Sophia, aka Angel in the Sky. You know, they got a talk show coming out.
G-Mama? G-Mama?
Yes, honey.
You can't be on the speakerphone. You got to come back off the speakerphone, G-Mama.
I'm not on the speakerphone, baby.
Okay.
Congratulations, my sister.
So, they got a talk show coming out called, Grown Woman Status. So, Joe, as a man in your standings, you know, what do you consider a woman at her grown woman status? Like, when you see this woman, you talk to this woman, you say to yourself, and that's a grown woman right there.
She handles herself. She handles herself. I'm talking as far as life. I mean, when you're doing life things, taking care of your kids, taking care of your home, if you got a man, husband, you're taking care of your man, you make sure everything is in the place. You even though the man is supposed to be the head, but they say, you know, that woman is that backbone. She handling her business, that's that woman. You know, she doing everything she possibly do. I'm going to give you a prime example. My late mother, working three jobs, even though we Jamaican, I understand that. You know, they always hold down a whole bunch of jobs. But working three jobs, taking care of me and my sisters, and going to hair school. You know what I'm saying? Even though she might have ran short of lights or ran short of food, she always made sure that rent was paid. You know what I'm saying? She did what she had to do to get out there. You know what I'm saying? So when you get out there, these new age moms that's doing it in this new age time, even the old school ones that don't handle their business with their kids, that's how you do it, you know? And I'm applaud the women that's taking care of kids by themselves. By themselves, where you got a man that just say, you know, forget it, and he's gone, and they handling it. They done went through that stress. They done prayed to God to help them throughout that. I mean, and they doing it. They doing it. They may have been on the system a little bit to give them a little push, but they got off it. They didn't stay on it and try to suck it dry like you got some, you know. But then you got some of them other ones that just use it a little bit, but then they get off their feet and they do what they need to do, and they take care of that family.
Okay, you go ahead on that. That was JoJo for y'all who don't know. Got a book coming out. Y'all may want to check that thing out. Robin Lynn.
Yes, ma'am.
How you doing again, sweetie? You okay?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. I'm not mad anymore. I forgave them because
okay.
They didn't give me my
so
pizza.
You ain't gonna take their clothes off and drag them on the road for a little bit, scan them up a little bit? You ain't going to do that?
I'm not going to trade bullets for my T-shirt. I'm away.
You know, you could throw some gasoline on them and then light a match. You could do that, too, now.
G-Mama.
Okay, maybe. But maybe I'm going wrong. I'm sorry.
Can I explain?
Can I explain the situation about her shirt?
Yeah, please do, because I don't know what's going on, because somebody's going to have to feel the fire.
This is what happened. We had already put the order in for the shirts before we met Mrs. Robin. So we are doing another T-shirt order. And once we get everybody to order the amount of shirts that we need, it will be in that order.
Oh, so there won't be a special order. You see how they're doing me, G-Mama? G-Mama.
See, I'm going to tell you what you're going to have to do. See, what you're going to have to do, you're going to have to watch Chainsaw Master. You need to watch that movie, Robin, and watch Chainsaw Master. Get that chainsaw and saw the door down. That's what you're going to have to do right there.
G-Mama. G-Mama, they really hurt my feelings. I didn't let them come in. They look, actually, they kind of big, you know. They got big, and so they don't come running in here doing their shows and stuff and multiplying shows, like sales, the split and stuff. I was scared.
Ooh.
And then so I cowered in the corner and stuff, and I'm just like waiting, and they come in every day. They turn the lights on. They do their little show and stuff, mop up the floor. They nice.
Uh-huh.
They clean.
Got their own little show going on and everything.
You promoting
and everything.
The team 103, but I ain't got no T-shirt. You see how they do me? They won't even special order for me. Make them.
Get the chainsaw. Get the chainsaw. That's what you're going to have to do to them. They'll change some minds, you know. So, look, hey, Dr. Lee, you know, let me ask you, because we're already in a conversation, you know. What is your thoughts? You know, say you don't live life for a long time. You don't experience a lot. I think you're probably the most experienced one up here right now. So, what are your thoughts? What symbolizes you? What do you consider a grown woman?
A grown woman.
A grown woman. Like, you see this woman? You say you. Go ahead.
Very comfortable with herself. Mm-hmm. Very just you know, when she makes a decision, when she makes a choice, she doesn't second guess it. Just very, very comfortable. You know, I don't know how else to say it. Just confident. But yeah, someone that's got you know, they take the time to think about it, organize. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
Organize.
Mm-hmm.
I'll say that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Faithful. Yeah. How about this? How about a virtuous woman? How about like that? Mm-hmm.
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 Wow.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah.
Like,
they prepare. They're ready. They're looking ahead. You know what I'm saying? They're aware of stuff. You know, if something comes up, They can look at the options and make decisions and choices. So, yeah. Yeah, and
like
fine,
that.
Too.
Yeah.
Fine.
Yeah. Well, you know, I remember what Rose said on one of his talk shows. He said he like a woman that knows that she could fit on a pair of jogging pants and still look good. She ain't got to wear no pants so tight that she can't fart.
Yeah, that's right. I don't care what she put on, she still look good.
Well, I am a little disappointed in all of y'all because I asked y'all the question and no one gave the right answer. The definition of a grown woman is G-Mama. Don't get it twisted. That's what you should have said. If you look up grown woman things, you will see a picture of G-Mama. Don't get it twisted. Don't even check yourself. Show is. Yeah, I wanna thank everybody, you know, for tuning in to Team 103 Talk Show Radio. This your girl G Mama, you know, brought you the How You Gonna Act and left people speechless. That's what it do. And for those who tuned in on the end, the top of that big boot head with the team was How You Feel About Facebook. Let me say this. I'm not on it, okay?
And I do see it sometimes, but I'm not on it. Do I like it? Do I hate it? I really don't care. Because I done got too old to be worrying about these folks. I ain't listening to nobody's music. The only thing I do, I just wait for every Wednesday from 9 o'clock for me to come on Bad Lies, Team 103 radio show, and bring How You Gonna Act. So I can tell you now, on Facebook, Wednesday night, 8 to 10, you won't see me up there, but you will hear me on the radio talk show, Team 103. And Special K, I'm going to ask you, you the host, is y'all going to bring G-Mama on the talk show? Do you and Sophia mind if I get up there?
No, ma'am. You can come on the show anytime you want to come on. Let us know.
But you know, I got some things to say about a grown woman. Uh-oh. Be no talk girl. I want to, appreciate everybody for tuning in, Hey, Robin, you got anything you want to share with us?
Oh, no, I'm just, I just thank y'all for letting me come to the show and sitting in the front row. Thank you.
Oh, no problem,
thanks.
No problem,
Thanks for keeping the vibes live.
We already know.
For sure.
Rose, you have anything that you want to say about the whole thing? Anything you want to put a little emphasize on?
Oh yeah, I got one thing that I've been waiting this whole from 8 to 10 to say.
Okay.
Go ahead. Oh yeah, shout out. Shout out to my, I'm sorry. Shout out to my brother Big Boo for putting all this together. You know, as he will always say, I'm his number one fan and always gonna be. You know, what I mean, he's Mr. King of Comedy, one of the best that I know, one of the ones that I know that I don't care. Whenever I see his mouth moving, I'm rolling.
Yeah.
I'm crying. You know what I mean? He's definitely nice with his craft. So, shout out to Big Boot for putting all this together because, Team 103, we've been doing this for years. You know, but we never thought that we'd make it this far and be worldwide on the radio show. Shout out to Big Boot in. Big Boot in key.
You don't test my heart, Dad. You know, my grandson, he does a lot. And my grandson, he just so happy that he got everybody doing, helping to go this thing. You know, a lot of people been putting in work, Special K, Rob Lynn, Most Morning, JoJo and everybody, G-Style, Rich, everybody just pretty much toning in and helping out. I sure appreciate the love. JoJo, if you have any legal words you like to say?
Is everybody out there, be safe, be easy. There's a lot of madness out there. Hoping to be here next week so I can get back to talking to G-Mama, talking to Robin Lynn and all my Team 103 sisters and brothers. And I love y'all.
I appreciate you. Special K, anything you like to add or anything before we go?
Yes, just want to thank Robin Lynn for giving Team 103 this opportunity to, let our light shine a little brighter. Thank Big Boot for actually doing this for us, helping us, shine a little brighter too. And I just love my team members. And y'all just be blessed and let's keep this movement moving.
Go ahead on, girl. God bless your heart. Sophia, you still with us?
I am.
Anything you want to add? Any words you want to say?
I hope everybody has a good evening and sweet dreams.
Sweet dreams. That's the angel in the sky. You go ahead on. I like what you're doing, girl. I like what you're doing.
Sophia. My eyes and my wings. Thank you.
Well, Sophia, my grandson was telling me something on Facebook that you're about to start doing. What's that you working on up in there?
Well, one of the things that I'm trying to work on is I'm trying to put together like a food or clothing drive. Because I'm trying to get more into, because I'm I grew up in a hospice, but I'm realizing
okay.
that a hospice really doesn't have organizations for kids or for, like, the homeless, runaway teens. So that's what I'm trying to research now. I think Greenville does. So I just want to, you know, try to do something for the surrounding area and try to put the team to work on trying to, you know, do that. Because I know part of the team's creed is to give back to the community, especially the kids. That's why you always got to stay positive. So that's something that I'm researching and trying to set up a meeting with somebody from an organization or something to kind of help the area that we all know and grew up in.
See, I knew you was an angel in the sky. I knew it. But anything you need, you know, you need help, you know, team on feet. We support you all the way, girl. Get that thing right. You know what I'm saying? We get
right, right.
So all you got to do, just let us know what you need, honey.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you. And please tell your grandsons, I know there have been a couple of things that I have missed. I'm so upset. I miss bowling. I have to definitely make it to the next function. I have to. So I do apologize for me physically being absent, but I had some things happen, but I'm definitely going to try to make the next one.
You just got to be careful about that bowling alley, because him and Roe, they be acting up down there.
I got a master sweeping the foot in the back, but I got it, though. I got it.
Once I get a couple of things,
I got it. Huh?
Okay. You better watch out, because I hear him and Tyaster, they be on that little game where you be killing them Terminators or something, and they will happen to fall.
Yeah, D Mama, we were shooting them up. See, we was the team that
he
night.
He told me you were rubbing on his leg. I don't know if that's true or not.
Don't get me.
You were rubbing. That's what he told me. Girl, I ain't got nothing to do with it. That's what he told me. Don't look at me. I ain't got nothing to do with it.
Don't get me on a shooting game. I go to the range. I ain't too many people going to see you cry, but, I mean, I just don't want to leave his eyes.
Mama, is you going to be with us on the 25th?
Well, you know, they say I may have to make an appearance, you know. Everybody show up. I think I'll be. You just call me, girl, and if y'all got people like to come out in the crowd. You know that. Mm-hmm. So I don't get out of my bed for nothing. You know, I need to know something going on. And you know, something going on. Gee, Mama, gonna be there. Yeah. So, see, that stuff you got going on. I don't think you want none of G Mama clothes. You know, but hey, the spider webs over here. Look, you know, a little radical. I ain't bought no clothes in about 10 years, but it feel all good now. A little wear and tear.
You ain't got no clothes in 10 years. I know I ain't never going to get my T-shirt.
I ain't got no clothes in 10 years. They won't look out for their grandma. You tell me, I'll do my same old clothes 10 years. That don't make no sense.
I'm out.
I want to thank everybody for tuning in. Once again, this is the Team 103 Radio Talk Show, live. Thank you, Ratherland. Tune in again next Wednesday, 10 to 10. Holler at the team. How do you say it, Ratherland?
Good night.
The Team 103 Radio Talk Show. 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 The Team up to Wednesday, tune in, you listen to him. A good friend, call the line and go to talk to him. Real talk, life situations, don't get it. This is the beginning of a movement, but if you get it, how you will act with this boot, if you get a question. I was shocked in the phone, I couldn't say that. To find out later, it was all true. You won't believe some of the things people go through. But here's what we do, reach out and help others. Booking up our brothers and supporting others. But it ain't all, we got music in our own movie. The best hope for music is from your food. So go to tune in and listen to your local track. Make it easy to hear us with how you act. You never know what the world people do. On the radio, where it's 213 true. It's 213 radio talk show. A backline, listen up, call it live. It's 213 radio talk show. So call the line to hear the video, it's team talking live.
Too many MCs do it like I done it. Done it. The whole hood love it. S-type, spit sick shit, hard to stomach. These other MCs wanna copy me probably cause I'm properly fitted. Headline, write rhymes, why would I could just spit it? I'm so committed. It's a shame how these lames thinking they can fuck with it. I'm on a whole nother level while traveling on the road to riches. Breezing past niggas that's wasting money on chasing bitches. Dressing like these hoes. These niggas starting to look suspicious. Only thing missing is tight pants to say delicious. Let's get back to that real shit. Ill shit. Grab the microphone and just kill shit. That's that shit. Them niggas I'm with put out. Bring the whole hood out like a motherfucking
cookout.
You know
cookout. This
bad incredible. Man's I'm incredible. World. I'm incredible.
Boy,
I'm
DJ,
incredible.
Yes.
I'm incredible. I'm incredible.
You know what it is,
I'm incredible. I'm incredible. I go too hard. My flow too strong. I go in all day long. I go too hard. My flow too strong. I go in all day long.
Can you hear the town and lay every MC down? Find a throne. Slap a nigga out his crown. Open up his show. He kidnap his whole crowd. No. Well, who you supposed to be? I spit that crack to turn a fan into a fiend. Shine so hard, they starting to call me Orsheen. I got that Kobe flow, them niggas got that soybean. Oh. See, they don't want no beef, cause I'm incredible, unbearable, unedible. Them niggas get my style and they say I taste terrible. Cause I'm the shit, I'm arrogant and confident. I'm on my high horse, with a blunt lit. Competition who? Competition well. I've been searching for someone, please take me there. I make your favorite rapper, drain his ink pen, throw his rhymes in the casket right before we jump in.
Let's go.
I feel a surge of adrenaline, I'm in need of Ritalin. Oh, I'ma feed my addiction for being a lyrical hitman. Really the nerve of these fellas, thinking that they could do better. No, I'm imported from Italy, you just patent leather. I keep my shit together like a dung beetle. Always bring the heat like a high fever. Handling my beef like a meat cleaver. Beast hate to see me, I'm the reaper. I got the killer flow. I'm in the cut like a knife head. But stick out like a biped. Lightning strikes, thunder roars, titans start clashing. Fighting with the hi-hats, shooting at the snare drums. At war with the beat, and murder is the outcome. Now imagine what I do to an MC. Cut him a rip, him shred him, turn a simple style. And miss me, I bring the beat. Southern hospitality, collard greens, cornbread, sweet tea, nacho. I'm incredible.
I go too hard, my flow too strong. I go in all day long. I go too hard, my flow too strong. I go in all day long.
I love listening to Vibes Live.
I'm a groovy type nigga, rather two-step with your pants sagging, rag dragging, rather game bang with your trigger squeeze. Don't call it, throw them thang things with your hot degrees, antifreeze, chilling cool with your chilling cool with your hot degrees, antifreeze, chilling cool. chillin' cool, cool with your rags, rags, my gang, bang, bang, bang. Groovy nigga jumped up off the bed, forced by my third leg, leave the fifth. No L's, no whips, backyard full of crisps. Barbecues and county blues, who would think some be the shit? It ain't much up on our list, shoot the killer, hit and list. Get EBT up off the bitch, gang bangin', fuck a click. Not looking for a sprout. See my gripping done spread around the world, but it's top below his bottom, Mr. Reaper. Reaper, Reaper, Reaper. Looking like a reaper in your driveway, straight through your living room. Live on the drive-by on a summer day, July 4th will be in June. Black tip, black tip, black tip, black bum. The sound of that drum that grips that blood flow. Black tip, black tip, black tip, black bum. The sound of that drum scene. I'm a groovy type nigga, rather two-step with your pants sagging, rag dragging, rather game bang with your drink. Squeeze dog, Cali, throw them thang things with your hot degrees, antifreeze, chilling cool, cool with your chilling cool, cool with your hot degrees, antifreeze, chilling cool, cool with your chilling cool, cool with your pants sagging, rag dragging, my game bang, bang, bang. Don't make me put a lean to a nigga, spleen, jail to a nigga, bad lean. Stop a dream in his tracks, beam down, little boy, now I dream, little boy, dream, dream. Coco in the pot, arming at my body, ASAP rocket, one that I can get it, onion in my pocket like the booty on a midget, diamond on my rollie, think a nigga out of frigid, looking at the time, saving, winning for a minute, see my neck, go defend it, what's the price? See my soul was long gone, before I got him, he was there before I shot him, Mr. Reaver, Reaver, Reaver. Through your living room, 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 room. Live on the drive-by on the summer day, day. July 4th will be in June, 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 June. Black tip, black tip, black tip, black bomb. The sound of that drum, that grips, that blood snow. Black tip, black tip, black tip, black bomb. The sound of that drum, scene. I'm a groovy type nigga, rather two-step with your pants sagging, rag dragging, rather game bang with your drink. Squeeze dog, Cali, throw them thang things with your hot degrees, antifreeze, chilling cool, cool with your chilling cool, cool with your hot degrees, antifreeze, chilling cool, cool with your chilling cool, cool with your pants sagging, rag dragging, my gang bang, bang, bang. Tell me more about it in the gutter, where it started with the crippin', brewing Kevin, so what happened? Tell me more about it in the gutter, where it started with the crippin', then the blessing got it back.
I'm just an east side nigga, when your niggas saying, show you what it be like, nigga. Hit 'em up, light 'em up, like a street light, nigga. Follow me, I can show you what these streets like, nigga. Handlebars of a swing, guns blow like rusty wind. Spin a bin, push his wig back whenever baller spins. Toe tag him, floss flagging like it's all good. Tell niggas tee off like Tiger Woods. Where you from? We never heard of ya. Walking with the murderers, niggas that'll murder ya. Steal you like a burglar. Seen the soul was long gone before I got him. He was dead before I shot him. Mr. Reaper,
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 Reaper.
Ain't no way he's done. Cause I'm pouring this pain, touching pain, it's a bad darling. Can I show you this world, baby? Ain't no rules in this life, darling.
The wrong nigga to cross and the first nigga to jam with the AK quattro CFAO a microphone in hand. Goddamn, generation Uno dungeon fam. The lab is filled with potions of emotions out the ass. I laugh when you think that you have seen the last, but it's only the beginning, my nigga. Don't be so fast, mad gas. I slow it down to a screeching halt. And beat the president, cause he no think before he talk. Iraq got that, now he gunning for Iran. North Korea got that shit that make LA look like Japan. Island, nah man, more like the Caribbean. Billy Ocean body potion, take a voyage to Atlantis.
Oh, yeah. Ice selling glass, lean blasted. Machinery swing past. Next stop, Bowling Green, bling flash it. Glow my ass off. Po-po, they try to harass. My dough, chain cash, and I sit in my castle bent. You know the W would come from dirty bass. Bird baths, let them stunt. We got burners with gas. Fly past by NASA. Caught up with the cash. Why blast when you know we in your crib? Bypass, I master. What? The treasure rug, getting ass, whip acid. Red pipe and leather, slick, nasty. Sassy, but at the same time, raspy. Plug me a thug, your mother eating plastic.
Styles will change, they say change is dangerous. As a king standing on the terrace, while his partner pointing up at the rifle man. Coward shooter, never know when your life will end. Then live like there ain't no motto. And if one come, then this the motto. Now I'll put message in Bato. You go to the nearest beach and open your cardo and walk to the place where the sea meets the land. Yeah, it's easier to run the street than walk in the sand. Hey, I'm talking, young man, as if chalk in my hand. I will take y'all the last to school. It's cool when the kids call me Sonny. The hood calls me Stacks. The bees call me Honey. Hollywood calls me Bat. Crack and I have a lot in common. We both come up in the 80s and we keep that bass pumping. That's a nigga. Tip comparison, embarrassing. Unfortunate that if you come up fortunate, the street consider you lame. Ha, I thought the name of the game was to have a better life. I guess it ain't, what a shame. I don't slang, never slung, but I'm one with the slum that has a name well fitting. Plenty cheese getting, no wonder why they called it the trap. So watch your tail, and I'm not kidding. The rats and mice would give advice. They say you can paint and draw. Get out of here, go show them that we're more than slang and raw. That's when I broke into my big Rube impression, and I tried to enlighten, but that night I learned a lesson that the morals that you think you got go out the window when all the other kids are fresh and they got new Nintendo Wii's, and your child is down on her knees praying hard up to God for a whopper with cheese. Do you B, hit the street hard with a flare, or do you A, go to school for heat in an air, dare make a honest living but make a crooked killing, or do a bit of both until you're holding on a million? Brilliant, you got one foot in, one foot out, you put your left foot back in, and then you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey till you turn your life around. That's what it's all about. 3,000 out.
That's all my daughter, homie. Ride or die for mine. You ride the bitch. See, that's some shit, love, homie.
I
it on me. On me. On me. On me. Homie, nobody got